So I want to talk about a song I just wrote. It's called Scapegoat Rapist. And in general, well, I want to talk about songs that I write on the spot. I mean, if I can remember the lyrics. This is a Drive Time program. I guess this is episode 14C, I believe. Don't quote me on that. I have this thing that I do, for lack of a better term. Okay, are we back on? We're back live? Okay. I do this thing I've been doing for a little while now. The thing predates the thing that I'm talking about here, which is the Twipella series, which is Twitter Acapella. It's a hybrid word I made up called Twipella, and I record these little tunes, and I post them on Twitter, and then collect them into various collections. I'm on to the second volume right now. There's been 500 total of these little songs. By himself, let's be real here, maybe a dozen of 500. Is gonna be a melody, a melodic idea, a melodic plus lyrical idea that works together and would be something I have interest in expounding. Expanding. What? Sometimes I use words and I know what that means. That's not what I wanted. Expand, I just want to expand on some of them sometimes, not all the time. I think I came up with one today, and it was a good one, and the reason I talk about that is because I think I'm having a jam session later today. I think I'm getting the band back together. So maybe one song we can try to figure out the actual chords beneath it is a song I wrote today called Scapegoat Rapist. And the lyrics are, I'm not sure if I can remember them all totally, but I'll try and slowly word sound them up from memory, because I write these, but let me backtrack for a second. I have this ability, I guess you could call it an ability, to create songs out of thin air. So they'll just come to me, and they'll do weird little tunes, maybe they'll start with the words, maybe they'll start with the notes. Oftentimes, majority of the times, it's both things happening at the same time. And so I took to my iPhone to record these, and now I just recorded them, and I actually have a backlog of about 10 or so that maybe I'll post today to Twitter. And then you can follow vernonhow.com or twitter.com/vernonhow, and you can see what I'm talking about with these little cute little tunes. They're cute. They're adorable. They are adorable. Anyway. It is what it is. I don't want to read into that. It's just a project that I do, and so. What I was trying to get at is that doing this dates back God knows how long. Oftentimes, I said oftentimes twice in this. And I told myself I wouldn't say oftentimes more than one time per episode of Drive Time, but that's what works. How it works out for this driving show. I gotta pick my words better a little bit, I guess. I told myself. Trains off the tracks. We have only a limited amount of time before this episode's over, so let me try and get this out. I've been doing this forever, so I only now have recorded 500 of these songs, roughly, over two volumes of Twipella, the second one forthcoming. In the process now, I want the second one to be 500 tracks long. We're going to do something different for Volume 3. But this is all in the future, so don't worry about that. Don't worry about any of this. But, forever I would just see my dog, or I would see something, and I'd be like, here's this tree, and I'm like, I'm going to be, and I'm going to be, and I would come up with some little ditty, and it would make sense and it'd be funny. And I don't think I'm the only person in the world that does that. But I am the only person in the world who records these hiccups, creative hiccups, and presents them as finished product art, musical art, in the form of the individual MP3s available via Twitter, via the Twitter feed for download per release, and also collected in several volumes in album form. So back to the song. So the song, today's song, I actually recorded about three songs today. One of the songs was Scapegoat Rapist. I like it. The lyrics go, I want to be a scapegoat rapist. Something like, because scapegoats have had their time. My fear is now or never. And never is the time that's always flying by. Let me just ruminate on that for a second. Just let that crunch that up in your mouth before you swallow. I think there's a song there. It occurred to me that just now in reciting the lyrics without singing it or without the melody, that it's a little off in terms of what I originally had, the idea that I guess I had. Well, the idea stems from, if you want to know how this works, is a lot of times, without a melody, I'll come up with, and a lot of these I post on Twitter, it's just fake song titles. So I'll come up with a fake song title, and every once in a while from there, I'll get a melody for something I think is a clever little wordplay. So in this case, I thought Scapegoat Rapist, which actually I might have even thought of as a fake song at some point earlier. It seems like something I had thought of before. So I'm thinking Scapegoat Rapist in the old head. And the melody comes, and then right now I realize that what I was really thinking of in the terms of those lyrics are people who make. So I want to rape. I don't really want to rape scapegoats. I want to rape, metaphorically speaking, rape people who make people out to be scapegoats. So what are those people called? Do they have a neat little name like scapegoat? They should be called, like, scape butchers. That could be a song right there, a different song from what I'm talking about now. Wow, this is good. This is good food for thought. This is a good one.